Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Nishita Singh and I take care of the glaucoma services at the Healing Touch Eye Center, Janakpuri, New Delhi. Today I'm here to talk about a very critical eye disease, glaucoma. Glaucoma is a disease of the optic nerve of the eye which gets damaged or degenerates due to the rise of the intraocular pressure. The intraocular pressure is the pressure exerted by the fluid inside the eye known as aqueous humor, which ranges between 8 to 20. At any point of time when the pressure increases more than the critical value, it exerts a damaging effect on the nerve of the eye, which leads to glaucoma.
Why is glaucoma known as the silent thief of sight? Every patient has a central vision and a field of vision. To explain it better, when you're driving a car and a car goes by your side, you don't have to turn to that car. You looking straight driving, you come to know that it's going from the sides. So this is your field of vision. In glaucoma, the central vision remains intact, but it is the field which gets affected. That is why patient doesn't come to know about the symptoms of the disease till its last stage. That is why it is very important to be aware and get screened for this deadly eye disease. What causes glaucoma? The most important risk factor or the causative factor for the disease is the intraocular pressure. At any point of time, when the pressure exceeds its critical value, it exerts a damaging effect on the nerve. Earlier, the pressure had only the people with high pressures were thought to be at risk of glaucoma. But with the better understanding of disease, the patient can have a normal pressure, but that pressure may be high for that patient, the entity critically known as the normal tension glaucoma group. The second causative factor can be the genetics. If glaucoma runs in your family, you might have glaucoma. The siblings or the first degree relatives are at a higher risk, and the children being the second at risk. Thirdly, there are certain group of people who are at a higher risk of glaucoma because of some disease, systemic or ocular, like a patient with diabetes or myopia is at a risk of a primary open angle glaucoma. And patients with high plus numbers, hyperopia, young middle-aged women are at a risk of close angle glaucoma. These are mainly patients of primary glaucoma. Now, if you have had any type of eye injury, continuous redness, or you've had trauma to the eye, or you've used steroids in any form for a long period of time, you can have glaucoma. So anybody with these kind of history of any age group should have a regular glaucoma checkup. Earlier, the disease was known to be only prevalent in people more than 40-50 years of age. But even the younger ones, the children can also have an entity of glaucoma known as congenital or developmental glaucoma. The children present with larger eyeballs and large corneas. So anybody with that and with a strong family history should get their children checkup for glaucoma. How do you diagnose glaucoma? There are three modalities critical for the glaucoma diagnosis and management: the intraocular pressure, the visual fields, and the optic nerve head testing. Now, intraocular pressure by far is the most critical and the modifiable factor. So the diagnosis of glaucoma primarily revolves around measuring the intraocular pressure, and if it is high, you are diagnosed, and then you are treated by various treatment modalities to decrease it to a target level. The second modality to diagnose glaucoma is the visual field testing, because it's the peripheral visual field which gets affected in glaucoma, not the central one. So a perimetry is the most diagnostic and the gold standard test to diagnose glaucoma accurately. The third, and which shows the earliest sign of glaucoma, is your optic nerve, because a rise in IOP directly first affects the optic nerve, then the visual field gets affected. A good comprehensive examination by your ophthalmologist can tell you very correctly without any tests also that do you have glaucoma or not. And now there are scanners to help the ophthalmologist to see the invisible layers of your optic nerve to pick up disease as early as possible. So the diagnosis is made with these three, taking these three parameters in consideration. How is glaucoma treated? The treatment revolves around three modalities. It's by drops, lasers, or surgery. The drops are the first line of treatment. There are various types of topical drops available to treat glaucoma, which act on the eye either by decreasing the aqueous production or by increasing its outflow, the goal being decreasing the intraocular pressure to a critical value. The drops are the gold standard treatment and the first line treatment which are given to any patient, but they come with the problems of side effects. You have to put them at a regular time, because like if it's 8 a.m. it has to be 8 a.m. every day. And after some time, because the drops are being used for a long time, they lose its effect. Otherwise, mostly patients of mild and moderate variety are very comfortable using the drops. The second modality, which is becoming very popular nowadays, is the lasers. Lasers are a painless permanent solution to decrease your intraocular pressure. They can be done inside the eye or outside on your white portion of the eye to decrease the intraocular pressure. They can either increase the outflow facility or decrease its production. They are becoming very popular with their less downtime, being an OPD procedure and a one-time procedure. But their success is also unpredictable in very high glaucomas and secondary glaucomas. Coming third to the surgery, glaucoma surgery works on creating an alternate drainage channel for the excess aqueous humor which is being produced, which leads to high IOP. So in a way, we are creating a bypass for the excess fluid to come out of your eye. It can either be done by trabeculectomy, which is a very old gold standard surgery in which we create a bypass channel between your eye and your subtenon space. The second being, the latest being the glaucoma drainage devices, in which this bypass is created by inserting a tube inside your eye, which pushes the fluid inside your eye into the subtenon space. These surgeries are very effective, safe, but are an invasive modality. The newer technique known as the minimally invasive glaucoma surgeries are less invasive, and they act in which we insert small stents inside the eye which use your natural outflow pathways of your aqueous humor to decrease the IOP. The surgeries are done with lot of caution and can be very successful if done properly, but a regular follow-up and a meticulous examination before doing a surgery is very important. To sum up, everybody is at risk of glaucoma, and because you come to know of the symptoms very late, early screening and detection is the key to fight against this disease. You will never get blind of glaucoma if you get your eyes checked regularly, follow your ophthalmologist instructions, have a regular follow-up. You put your drops regularly at the scheduled time. In case of any problem with the drops, side effects, redness, blepharitis, consult your ophthalmologist. If you are putting your drops, don't think that your pressures might be in control because you are putting your drops. Get your pressures checked regularly. 6-monthly investigations of your visual field and optic nerve testing is mandatory for every glaucoma patient, and yearly screening for glaucoma suspects is necessary. Everybody above 40 years and whoever is at a risk with a known family history, steroid use, trauma, constant redness, and children with large eyeballs and corneas should get yourself screened for glaucoma. Together, we can all fight this blinding disease. Thank you very much.